with the music.
Ravishing Rick Rude.
What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, out of shape, Pennsylvania pissants.
Wow.
Button your lips and open your eyes while I give you the past, the present, and the future of professional wrestling. The Generation X.
My introduction. My Ravishing Rick Rude, and here they come on our first home play. Along with Shawn Michaels and China. Who really wears the pants in the family is what I'm wondering. I don't know that it matters. Watching us live, ladies and gentlemen, and it's all in Calgary, Alberta, Canada. A man who refused to be here tonight as a result of the comments and the actions of that man last week. We're talking about Bret the Hitman Hart, the best there is, the best there was, and perhaps the best there ever will be. But all of that will come to a head this Sunday on pay-per-view when Shawn Michaels and the Hitman get it on. And it wouldn't surprise me if you said earlier on, JR, that it was going to be the very last time they would ever be in a ring together.
It's going to be very, very special. We'll salute all our fans watching across Canada on TSN. We're looking forward to seeing you this Sunday in Montreal on pay-per-view.
Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid.
What does that gesture mean?
I have no idea.
Well, I'm just wondering.
They are degenerates, and they are proud of being degenerates. And if Shawn Michaels does become the WWF champion, who knows what's going to happen?
Shawn Michaels. Let's take you back to this past week on Raw. Bret Hart versus the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, for the WWF Championship. Near the end of the matchup, you came from out of nowhere, look at the Titantron, and interfered.
Oh! Ever the opportunist.
Now, perhaps now, as you see Ken Shamrock.
Shamrock could have become the WWF champion.
Should be the champion right now.
Whoa! Wait a minute, did he just...
Perhaps now, Shawn Michaels and D-Generation X, you may have...
You've talked enough. Let me tell you something, Michael Cole. You know, D-Generation X has come out here week after week. Shut it. We've come out here week after week. We've given you an extremely hard time, and you've done one heck of a job. Most people would have taken off by now, and God knows we've run out our share of announcers. You've done a heck of a job. Put it here. It's right. You deserve all the...
Oh.
And that just about does it.
No, he shouldn't take that.
No.
Okay, now that we've had the comic relief, it's time for the wrestling world to hear it from the lips of the man. As everyone knows, the Heartbreak Kid is the showstopper, the main event, the icon of the World Wrestling Federation that can still go. But now I have decided to take it up one level higher. From now on, Shawn Michaels will always be known as the wrestling...
No, Sean. Now, I'm your friend. I'm your best friend. And I know where you were going to go with that. Right. But you might be the icon, and you are the showstopper, but let me tell you what. To be the god, you actually have to be as old as God. To be a god, you had to be there when Pontius Pilate made the turn. You had to be the main event in the Colosseum when the wall came down. And you had better be able to walk on water if you expect anybody to watch Age in the Cage.
Okay, Triple H, you've made your point. But one thing is for sure, at Survivor Series, I will show Bret Hart that I am indeed the man. But what I want to comment on right now is what everybody was talking about last week. Everybody is upset because last week, Shawn Michaels cracked a few people up.
So to speak.
But that is nothing, nothing compared to what I'm gonna do next week.
Wait a minute.
Next week, I've got two things I'm gonna do. First, the Heartbreak Kid is gonna come out here and walk naked.
What? What is he talking about? Good God.
He's gonna what? Wait a minute. This is going entirely too far.
And then the next thing that I'm gonna do is take the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, and show him the world's most dangerous man.
I guess by that he's going to challenge Mr. Shamrock.
Everybody knows DX calls the shots. So Slaughter, why don't you get out here and make that match official?
Well, I can tell you the commissioner is watching this because of what...
Come on, Chin, get out here!
Of what Michaels did last week.
In order!
The commissioner forbidding Michaels to drop his trowel...
Come on, Chin Man!
Anything at all like
big,
that.
Big, huge chin down here.
He said and he's going to be naked,
rope
McMahon.
Ropes open so you can get it in.
And this is interesting that Shawn Michaels and DX would actually call out...
Make it official, big
Commissioner
man.
Commissioner Slaughter. Asking for a match with Shamrock.
Let me get this straight, HBK.
Next week.
You want Ken Shamrock in a match here next week on Raw?
Hold on.
What? Give. They'll do anything to humiliate anyone.
Let me get this straight again. You want Ken Shamrock here next week?
Hold on, this isn't working.
What are these two degenerates up to now?
That's a sophomore class field trip.
Harpo and Groucho.
Get ready.
Now you can go.
Oh, they're a riot. Windshield wipers.
I remember guys like you at boot camp, real cute. But we had ways to straighten them out. Let me tell you, you want Ken Shamrock next week right here on Raw? Well, there's one stipulation. You are going to wrestle Ken Shamrock, but it's going to be tonight right here on the War Zone.
Uh-oh.
I don't think that's what they had in mind.
No, they definitely didn't have that in mind, I can tell you that. They did not have it in mind because here Michaels, in the match of his life this Sunday against Bret the Hitman Hart, the match of his life, this is the last thing he would want, to face Shamrock as Bret faced Shamrock.
I know how you used to straighten guys out in boot camp, Slaughter. But this is the World Wrestling Federation.
It sure is.
I'm going to straighten you out.
Sorry. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we will have a match, and it will take place tonight, not next week. Michaels has outsmarted himself.
I'm Shawn Michaels. You can't talk to me that way.
Michaels, one-on-one with Ken Shamrock.